Hi friends, today we have with us Shilpa Ramesh Ramani, and she is the co-founder of One Page Spotlight. And One Page Spotlight is a platform for artists and for small business owners in India. It's kind of a social networking site, a community site where people can come and they can tell about their profession, about their services, and they can interact with each other. Or I think Shilpa would be the best person to tell more about it, but this is something very basic that I have said, but let's hear it from Shilpa. Shilpa, hi, welcome to A Ball Full of Candies. Right, Shilpa.
Hello.
So please tell us about the platform, One Page Spotlight. A basic introduction for our audience to know about it. Yeah.
Okay. So One Page Spotlight, in a tiny bottle, should be. It's a professional social network solely for artists. Okay, where we cut out the noise that comes from the other kind of people, where authentic artists can actually meet up, create, connect, and collaborate. And not just create, they can connect with each other. Of course, that is the whole purpose of a social media platform, and collaborate. Now, what we are trying to do with social, One Page, we have so many other social medias. The key word is professional. All right. So in all the noise that comes in Facebook or Instagram, who are our competitors, what we are trying is lock down and come, bring together or create a hub for artists where, and position it globally, where they can actually talk to each other and, connect, create, collaborate, of course, and also monetize the time that they spend on social media, rather than while away their time. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that, in brief, is One Page Spotlight for you.
It is like the LinkedIn for artists, right?
Perfect. Yes. Perfect. But we just are not limiting ourselves to just connecting them and leaving them there. What we're trying to do is kind of empower them. So the idea of One Page Spotlight just does not limit to connecting people or just allowing them to create and put up their content there, all right? So what we are helping artists do is monetize their work, all right? So, like quoting the Dead Poets Society, actually, I've been meaning to quote this for a long time. You know, it's like every other profession has a place for themselves where they can go and monetize. See, unfortunately or fortunately, a value of a person or a value of a profession is, kind of goes up when there is monetization, when there's economic value to it.
Correct.
All right. So artists performing, non-performance, creativity is something that does not, the only place that you actually kind of monetize is probably the film industry. Mm-hmm. And then, also you have to be really big enough to reach the Christie's or Sotheby's and, go and pitch your art. So how about creating a simple democratic platform for artists, right?
Yeah.
So that they can, any creative person, so where they can just, what happens in a social platform like TikTok or others, where you just put up, of course there are opportunities for you, but there's no scope for you to monetize. And the key word here is kind of create this base where you can, create, get some monetization value for your, work of art, and you're not whiling away your time just creating content and dumping it on the social media. That's the whole purpose.
So, yes. So basically you are creating an infrastructure. You're kind of putting it in structure, there. Otherwise, this is a very unregulated, unstructured kind of an industry. There are a lot of players. There are a lot of professionals. We are full of them. India. Oh my God. I would say that I know many people who fear to go into a career because they already know it's a crowded space, right? And they don't know where to interact with, whom to get in contact with, and how to start it. This is brilliant. This is so good. Now tell us the story. How did this idea come to you or your partners? How does this whole thing happen?
So this is incredible, because it is when you fall that you try to rise up. It's probably like a fight against the monopoly that existed around us when we tried to break into the cinema industry. All right. So, yeah. So I am also, I've tried my luck with production. So we produce movies as well, and regional movies mostly. So I mean, I got into this profession around 2011 by my academic forte. I am actually a dentist. Okay, so I am an accidental entrepreneur, but so I haven't and more of an academician than actually working on media entertainment. This was something totally new.
Correct.
But what you think is, if you have the capital, you think you can, you have a set of creative people, you think that you can actually crack and you enter this industry. But it wasn't so. So then when we entered this industry, we saw there was, creativity. I mean, like when you look at a movie, you just look at a hero, a heroine, and the main lead characters or whatever, the director, the, the main people contributing to the cinema.
Yeah.
Yes. But there is more. There is a vast crew that stands behind and allows one movie, to come up, onto celluloid. And so that's when we thought we have to create a, I kind of went into real sadness where we have to, not only do they not get credits. I mean, of course, who sits at the end of the movie and actually looks at credits, right?
No.
So we came up with this idea. Yeah. So we thought, what is the best thing to do? Okay. So we used something that was already available. That is a social media or a technology, a platform. I mean, we thought of bringing in technology and aligning it with the entertainment industry to create a hub for these kind of people. So the idea was a seed format. We never thought of bringing in a lot of other form of, art forms in the initial stages. We were focused mostly on this particular genre that we were focused on. We were thinking of bringing in the camera people, connecting people, vendors to, vendors to the sellers or buyers or whoever, whatever. Mm-hmm. So it is only after we kind of, started getting onto the tech, started creating this and we started doing our market research. That's when we realized there's a whole set of people who've been ignored. They are a voiceless set of people who are absolutely ignored. And we thought that, we must actually do something to give them a voice. And that's the seed of this platform. We have had several reiterations in getting this platform right. We still haven't cracked it. All right. If you really say it's all in the making. So if you see, we are still half baked.
Correct.
But the traction that we have got is amazing. Because that is the kind of, there is something called opportunities on our platform. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we have several features. So then we had to think about features. So if you just go to the kind of opportunities that we have posted on our platform is amazing. And that is where, I feel like we just launched it last February, March. So, it is still in the initial stages, but we really want to get a lot of traction. There's a huge data that is lying with us. And I hope that we are visible enough for a lot of people who are actually walking around the streets trying to create stuff, but don't know where to put it. Yeah, on their own. Don't know where to go.
Yeah. Yes, actually, this is a very... you come to this kind of a platform, you notice that okay, something is there. I think most people just don't realize that this issue was already there with a whole lot of people that was bringing you entertainment on your screens. We know about the film stars, we know about the producers, directors, their problems, their issues. We never get into the crew. We never go and ask the spot guy, hey, how's your life going on, right? We heard about the hurdles that they have been facing since the COVID situation. But no, I don't think we have ever addressed something like this to about the industry or about the whole lot of people out there. Right.
Yes. What about writers? Yes. There's so many. If you just surf, if you just Google out, you just see. All right. The digital media has actually disrupted the world of books. All right. So Crossword and Landmark, we're losing out on you know, people like us walking in, and we thought, okay, everything is available on Kindle. Now, how do I create a space where people can actually access publishers? We have this platform where you can do this.
I had no clue.
Yeah. So that is the kind of network effect that we are trying to bring together.
Because many people, before even start their journey, there are different kind of people with different kind of, strategy. For me, I would be, before starting, if I want to write a book, before even starting to write the book, I would rather research where is the publisher, who will take my book. I hear so many stories like people get rejected. I want to be prepared. But then whom should I contact for that? So this is, yes, that is one great hurdle that people really face. Yes, interesting.
Yeah, what do you do about, I mean, another form of art? What about artisans, folk art?
Oh, God.
You know, where do they go? They're all stuck with middlemen. Even the, yes. So how about taking, like, you know, art from the local to global? I mean, we'll get there. I mean, so I'm keeping that for the last. But then, yes, it's a journey.
It's a journey. Somewhere we have to get started. Yes.
Yes.
So that's great. So when you build a platform and there is a host of things, to bring it to the people, get it noticed, to reach out, it is a whole lot of game. I mean, to have one idea, invest money, create that platform is one thing. That is when you are having it in your control. Take it to the people, get people engaged with that. Like you said that you have got a tremendous traction on your platform. So I'm sure, I personally believe I can understand this, that has been a whole lot of work by your team. So tell us about it. How did you go to people? How did you convince people to come and join the platform? Because this is again another social networking. And how did you do that? I really want to know.
All right. So the time of our launch could not have been not so good.
Yes.
And that was exactly in February where
COVID was
everything
in the,
was shut. All right.
Somewhere in the periphery. Yes. Yes.
In March. Yes. Yes. So the time. So what we did, our initiatives, we had a whole lot of, steps or plans and branding and, putting things in place. We had all the plans put in place.
Absolutely.
But no, nothing worked. So what we did was we stopped all those initiatives and we took the digital route. And we've been fairly successful in that. I think we kind of got really lucky because what we started was like this, this singer called Ricky Cage. All right. So he is the one whom we collaborated first. So he was doing this, an ensemble of a production for the, aligning with the WHO.
Okay.
So we collaborated with him. And then that was our initial step. We were like clueless how to go about it in COVID. All right.
Correct.
So, yeah. So that was our first event. So what we aligned with Ricky Cage, who aligned with the WHO. And then there was a series of people somewhere around the Lady Gaga time. I mean, around the time when Lady Gaga had a concert. Immediately after that, we had the Ricky Cage concert, which got us traction from around the world.
Mm-hmm.
Which was a blessing in disguise because everybody there were no movies, there was nothing available. And here we were an Indian, team. Throwing out, we had a concert on our social media. And that is where our traction started coming into our, platform.
Correct.
Yes. So we did not even, to be precise, we did not even have our app at that time. All we had was our website and we started getting our traction. Mm-hmm. After which was actually, it gave us this momentum where we started aligning with a lot of events. So what we meant to do offline, like going and meeting people, we started aligning with people and collaborating and creating several events, which got us a lot of traction. So people were there, all these people, we had art and we had art lovers, all of them coming in to our platform. Yeah.
Right.
So that was the first step. So the next step was to reach out to people individually. We had several initiatives that came out. One thing that we did interestingly was we participated with the Inktober thing in October.
Inktober.
Which got us amazing traffic. Amazing traffic again. Yes. So you see, there are different genres of artists who are actually aligning. So where we had Ricky Cage, we had international artists, international audience coming in. Then we had this Carnatic, we collaborated with Mr. Gautam Udupa and a series of people with Mr. Narayan. I mean, like, you know, several Carnatic artists. And then we went ahead and created the, we had Mr. Godkindi on our on our platform, doing his taking instrumental, and then we moved to Carnatic, where we had several aligning with Mr. Gautam Udupa. We had that event, so we had loads of people coming in from different genres at different times. So basically, in a nutshell, loads of events for all different genres, which kept people engaged during the COVID situation and got us traction. So that was one stage, all right? So now talking about Inktober, we had artists, you know, creative artists who were actually, I mean, it is a huge thing. Again, we had an international set of people coming in.
Yeah.
In fact, we also collaborated with, several TV channels, which also kind of put out our artists. So the artists were very, very happy. Yeah, artists were very, very happy. I mean, if you're collaborating with the WHO, of course, lakhs and lakhs.
It's a win-win.
So the visibility was huge. Yeah. And all that, I think, was a blessing in disguise. But we never thought that we would be able to do that. Like, you know, we got accidentally lucky, but it was a whole, I mean, like, I'd give that, this thing to my, co-founders and my team who worked, went out of the way. My team is pretty young. All right. So
I have seen them working.
It's not like they're aware of how to crack the situation.
Yes. Yes. Brilliant.
Yeah. So, yeah. And right from the ideation to execution and implementation is all by the team. Okay. I mean, all I have to do is trigger this, tiny idea and then take it, which touch wood, I'm very lucky that way that, so far, they've been absolutely brilliant. I think we have quite a few trump cards coming out in the next few months, and we should be doing pretty well there too. And then we have a great, onboarding team also, which is like fantastic, which reaches out to the real big artists. And we, in fact, have our own set of people managing several, artists who actually, are happy to give away their stuff to us so that their content is managed by us, in a very professional manner where their content is not misused and it's safe with our hands. So we also have that team. So that way, I think our initiatives have been mostly offline, but fantastically done. But we will step out now. We will have a lot of collaborations. We will be visiting all the exhibitions, museums, the publishing houses, and we will be onboarding all of them.
Right. I think, Shilpa, that your team doing so much well and so much of work, I think that tells a lot about you and your co-founder, your partners, because, when the leaders are so, so wonderful, the team, it naturally comes the best out of the team. So I must, say that you guys are definitely great leaders, right? Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, Shilpa. Shilpa, the first thing that was striking for me, okay, something that I will honestly I'll say that was not expected, was something unexpected. That is the branding aspect of One Page Spotlight. It's something very different. Like when we think, because see, it's how we have fed ourselves, conditioned ourselves. When we talk about Indian artists, Indian culture, so we kind of. The colors that comes into our mind is very, kind of saffron, red, yellow, all those elements. But when I saw the color or the branding of One Page, it was definitely something else. It was beyond like, it's just some corporate, page or something very professional or something very corporate-ish. So tell us about the branding. It's different and you are catering to a very different audience and you're bringing them together. Tell us about that. Yeah.
Okay, so there are several aspects to this, all right? So the idea, the line of idea, when you start thinking about branding, the ideal, the line that I would, I had given to my team was the dance of the cosmos. You know, the two greatest artists, I mean, in the Hindu mythology are Shiva, the dancer himself, and Krishna, the musician himself, right? So what is the color? What is the hue that you see? It's blue, right? Yes. So now when you look, when you talk about the dance of the cosmos, right? It is the sky, all encompassing sky,
space, yeah,
and the waters below, yes, right? So if you see the O for the one page spotlight, it's not, you know, it goes half, yes, and then there is a half.
That, absolutely.
You get what I'm saying?
Yes.
So
yes,
it is the dance of the cosmos encompassing the sky and the waters from below.
Great.
Yeah.
Great.
So that is where we get
the shape.
Oh, as one page spotlight. It's got nothing, it's got nothing to do with O of the one page spotlight. It's more to do with the cosmos in itself, the divinity and the color, the hue. Okay. That is why blue. All right. And it is, the color blue is something that is aligned with art. If you see some of the greatest artists, right? Van Gogh, everybody has
experienced.
There was a series in the last
name.
Yes. Yes. So they started experimenting because they started experimenting the blue color much later. It was different.
Yes.
It was So that is why the color blue was chosen. And the reason being simply, the sky and the ocean below with the divine dance all over. And if you see, I don't know if you have actually seen our ad, the branding video of ours, because the entire earth, circles off to the O, of the one page spotlight. And that's the reason for. So we are a globally positioned brand. We can go on and on about the non-design aspect of it, where because we are a very globally positioned platform. So obviously I will it's round and,
Absolutely. Great. All encompassing. Yeah. Okay, so let's come to Art Nirbhar Bazaar. That is one initiative that is going on right now. Yes, and I would I think I met your team pretty late. I wish we met them earlier, and we could cover the entire event that is going on. To start in the beginning of the event, but still, I would love to hear about Art Nirbhar Bazaar. What kind of traction it is getting? And just tell us about this online flea market idea and how is it going on currently? Tell us about it.
Okay, so the online flea market, the idea simply is to bring in people from the entire corner of India so far. And we also coincidentally it aligned with the local to global propaganda that these people Prime Minister actually yes it is just we did not come up with that. We came up with the Art Nirbhar Bazaar much earlier than that. We were working on it and we aligned with them, so we thought, all right, chalo, we'll piggyback on that.
Correct.
All right, yeah. So the idea is to bring in every bigger this is the e-commerce feature of One Page Spotlight. So we have several other features, right? So where we have content focused, we have we have the blog, which is content focused, and there's stuff like where I don't know if I can actually tell out a lot of features that are still in the pipeline, but yes, there are we have these communities, we have these tutorials that is happening, the education this thing that is coming up. All right, so the edtech part of One Page Spotlight. Okay, mm-hmm. So but what we are actually focusing on right now is because towards the e-commerce, we are still refining ourselves in terms of tech, but the e-commerce part of One Page Spotlight is what we are trying to pitch with Art Nirbhar. All right, so what we are trying to do is give a voice to the entire set of artists from the corners, two-tier and three-tier cities, not just those that are available, I mean, like, you know, in metros. Yes. We're bringing all of them, bringing in even the middlemen, I mean, like, you know, even collaborating with some middlemen, some sellers. There are a lot of sellers, you know, who do not know where to position their products. So we are bringing all of them, we're giving them this opportunity where you will be seen for your work, where your art form or art work will not hide behind probably a cosmetic brand or, you know, like a maybe a, how do you say, a bigger fashion brand, right? Correct. If you go to, yes. So like if a person is coming up with some artifact, like we have this seller who actually deals with, you know, artifacts, particularly sculptures, all right? So, but the point is, these people do not, they're all lying in the sides of roads. For example, even Chenpatna toys or any, I mean, like, you know, there are they're all sold on the sides of the road. That's not the place that they're meant to be.
And, yes, and those big, bigger brands sometimes take a lot of advantage of these. They exploit their, you know, gauri ke bhaav mein kharido and karoro mein becho kind of thing. That recent Amitabh Bachchan movie, it was like, you know, he sells this chair in some, for some peanut rate. There was this movie of Amitabh Bachchan and the other guy, I forgot his
name. Anshuman Khurana?
Yes, Anshuman Khurana, where he sold his chair, his ancestral chair, in some peanuts, and it got sold in some lakhs. So that is a truth, actually. Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, for example, let me tell you about these, the story of stoles, all right? Simple stoles that are being sold, all right? So these things on, the, I mean, like if you go to Goa, they're sold on the roadsides, right? But it is when the international audience, thanks to tourism, when they come and pick it up and they wore it, you know, in some international forum, we thought, oh, it's our product, right? So that is, so... I mean, the spending, we have the spending power, but we always like to look at the West. So why not bring in the direction, you know, the attention of the West or the international audience to us? And the best form is technology. So that is what we are trying to do here. And we are having, I mean, the signups have been amazing. We have close to 100 art, I mean, like, you know, sellers at the moment. All right. Just a few days into the,
Yes, I think, you know, January, you are winding it up, right? Yes.
So we will, I mean, we really hope to extend it because the demand for the products is really very high. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. So I think, I think there are niche products. Mm-hmm. There's, I mean, like today my team is going and meeting up with with a person who will be selling up sticks. Like, you know, beautifully, you know, carved sticks. All he deals with is sticks.
Yes.
You know, wouldn't geriatric patients or like old people be happy to have, you know, a beautiful stick, right? I mean, yes, there should be art rather than, it should be art rather than, you know, just a plain stick. So there's art in everything that we are seeing. And what we are trying to do is give visibility to these kind of products. Correct. That people can actually, you know, come and, you know, source these products and from the nook and corner of India and, you know, hopefully we'll do a good job there. And I mean, if you really want to know, I don't know if I should actually mention the statistics. We have more than, you know, products more than 2 crores worth.
Oh,
so lying on a platform. So, I mean, that is a lot of
big.
Yes. For a tiny platform like ours at the moment.
You have started just now,
Yes. So I think, I mean, like, you know, hopefully we will, I mean, we should do a lot of promotion for our, I think we have not worked really hard thanks to New Year. We have to really work hard and get more people to come in and, you know, pick these products and, you know, create a network. And we have this, I mean, we have this feature. I mean, see, let us not limit the Art Nirbhar Bazaar to just until January 15th. All right. We have something called the Blue Store.
Yes.
Which is an e-commerce aspect. So where we are permitting sellers, not just artisans, not just a small a seller, small time seller. We have, when I'm talking about crores, that means people, you know, even we have high end buyers high-end sellers and people from the bottom rung. But all, imagine if Manish Malhotra and Sabyasachi would give space for, an artisan from, say, Kutch to come and participate. Of course, the visibility is going to be beyond understanding. Right?
Beyond the shoulder of the giant. Yes.
Yes. Yes. So what we are trying to do is the same. We are creating a confluence of both these kind of buyers and sellers, so that there is, people. I would buy stuff from anywhere. You would buy stuff from anywhere if you actually showed me where these. Yeah. If you show me where I can, get these beautiful artifacts or beautiful things. So you must come. I know that you have checked our checked out, but I think
I did. Yeah, I love checking.
Yeah. Yes. So yeah.
So we are having a very less time for our interview. Okay. So this is a one question that I love asking people. Okay. This is about. See, whenever we do something in our life and it really drives us to, to get going, despite whatever difficulty life throws on us. So spirituality plays a very important role, aligning our spirituality, resonating, with our belief system and, what drives us in life. So tell us about how spiritually you feel that, this really resonates with your, entire, your mind, your soul, your heart. Because, this is just not about business. This is not just about helping someone and being the, good person and do something for the world. No, it is something also comes from inside. So I'm sure spirituality plays a role. I am a big fan of asking people about their spiritual journey. So yes, I would love you to share something, Shilpa. Before we wind up.
All right. Yeah. So it might seem as a coincidence or a deliberate attempt, but the idea in itself came in post I started my yoga practice.
See, I knew.
So, yes. Yes. So, okay, I am an Isha practitioner, but I wouldn't, I don't do same here. Oh, okay. High five then.
High five.
So, I think the idea. Okay, if it means anything to us, so our guru is there on our platform.
Absolutely. Oh yes, I have seen him.
So we ensure.
I loved. I saw him and I was overjoyed. I'm like, okay, this gives the the stamp of approval.
Yes. So he has been. He's there. So his team is aligned with us. Honestly, I would say he was a subconscious inspiration, probably driving in ways that I do not know. All right. So he always talks about, he has something called Isha Sanskriti, right? Right. So where he has emphasized on, Sadhguru has actually emphasized on, art, literature, art in itself, different types of art forms and the role of, art forms in itself.
Absolutely.
And art forms in itself and what the role that they play in aligning our whole system. All right. So if hypothetically, where do these kids from Isha Sanskriti who are focused only on art their entire lives, where do they go after this?
Correct.
All right. This kept running in my mind and I think they also do their, schooling side by side. And then do they actually align and go elsewhere? Will they give up on art after practicing, 10 to 12 or 14 years?
Absolutely.
Do they do it? Right? No. So platforms like this were, our requirements for aligning something, as deep as that. But going back to my spirituality, yes. That spirituality is the single most factor that has driven me to this. And I really hope that we stop giving, importance to economics as much as doing what we really love, creativity and passion.
Yes, let's build a economy.
And that is what we live
for. Absolutely. Beautiful. And see, I think our gurus are connecting us, you know, somehow in his own way. Yeah, this is wonderful. Yes. Shilpa, it was awesome. It was a beautiful experience, you know, to talk to you, you know, not just for the sake of this conversation, but, you know, so many things you understand when you get to see the perspective and understand the whole mission with this kind of initiative that you guys are doing. It is wonderful. And I'm really honored and I'm really blessed actually to, you know, to come in connection with these kind of things with my platform that I'm working on. So A Ball Full of Candies is, as I said, is for the small business owners. So we are focused on small business owners. We also want to get them, you know, grow their business somehow. And that is how, right?
Amazing initiative. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure talking to you. Let us build a better India together.
Absolutely, Shilpa. Such a great thing to say. Yes, absolutely. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
You call yourself an artist. On what ground? Drown, baby, drown. Download the One Page Spotlight app for artists.